do you love the Paterberg?
Oh, it's terrible. Terrible.
Enjoy it, man. Good job. See ya.
We'll get a proper time gap at the top and we'll know what the score is going into the final few kilometers. He's got one left turn to go and then 13 kilometers to the finish.
Steep climbs, cobbles and crosswinds, but it is here on the top of the Paterberg to the finish in Oudenaarde where the final chapter of the Tour of Flanders unfolds. 250 kilometers, but from the top of the Paterberg, the final climb, the final 14 kilometers unfold like the final thrilling chapter of a novel you just can't put down. At the top of the climb, the camera usually captures the riders cresting and suffering as they go left, driving down to the shelled river valley, the lush green farmland, and of course on to Oudenaarde. And watching on screen, the fans will count the number of seconds from the leading group to the chasers, because that becomes the baseline for the developing drama from here to Oudenaarde.
Take a deep breath, because it's going to be a nervous last 13 kilometers for everybody to watch. If they work together behind, surely they'll catch him.
Coming off the Paterberg is twisty, technical, with plenty of road furniture and roundabouts to catch you off guard when your tension is running low. And here on the 9 kilometer flat that runs northeast into town, there's always a possibility of crosswinds. Let's think back to 2019 with the solo attack by Alberto Bettiol. At the top of the Paterberg, he had about 15 seconds in hand and behind an attacking group with Peter Sagan, Greg Van Avermaet, and Matthew Vanderpool. The attention was rising. Instead of cobbles and climbs, it was mind games and anticipation. Bettiol had about 15 seconds by this point here, holding off the best names in cycling behind chasing, because instead of working together to help one another to try to win the race, each one was thinking about his own win, with everyone losing. The year before is a similar scenario, with Dutchman Nicky Terpstra solo ahead of the solo Dane Mads Pedersen and behind a chasing group with an attacking Peter Sagan. Everyone's attention was on the closing kilometers in the top left screen, and watching the numbers, the time gaps, as if it was the Dow Jones heading into the closing bell. In 2020, it was just two men, Matthew Vanderpool, Wout Van Aert, going at it like a long, drawn-out tennis match. The chasing group behind was too far back, so we could focus our attention only on those two, watching every facial expression, every muscle movement in the closing kilometers from here to Oudenaarde.
Look at that.
Well, 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 how quickly are they finishing behind? And they have virtually ground to a halt on the front, and they're coming like a train behind. This is a huge gamble that Mathieu van der Poel and Wout van Aert are taking.
I'm in Oudenaarde on the top of an overpass where the Ronde van Vlaanderen, the Tour of Flanders, finishes. It used to finish in Ninove after a long run off the top of the Bosberg. Now it's after a tension-filled run from the Paterberg. And since the move here in 2012, we've had winners such as Tom Boonen, Fabian Cancellara, and Alexander Kristoff. Terpstra would finally break Pedersen's hopes in 2018, and the chaotic chase behind imploded, and Bettiol went on to win in 2019. And it wasn't until here in Oudenaarde, after the final closing kilometers, the high tension from the top of the Paterberg, did we know about Matthew Vanderpool and Wout Van Aert. And one last push, one final explosion, Matthew Vanderpool settled the duel. He won the match and mastered the Tour of Flanders in those seemingly inconsequential kilometers from Paterberg to Oudenaarde.